Hello. So this is the sound I've got for now, so I can't really check my levels and stuff with it. However, it seems my mic audio is okay. Let me know when you know that, when you can hear it, and let me know. So, yeah, I've been meaning to get around to Inscription for a while. I was always like, oh, I'll get it on Switch when it comes out on Switch. And there was no word of it for ages and ages. And I was like, oh, well, it's on offer on Steam. I'll get it now. I actually think I'm going to lower the volume a little bit because I'm... I think the statics... yeah. So I've been meaning to get it for a while. I got it on Steam, and then as soon as I got it on Steam, it got announced for Switch. So I was like, oh, maybe I'll wait for the Switch version. Switch version comes out, and I'm like, but maybe actually what I want to do is play it on stream. So that's what I'm going to do. I want to have like a record of how I do, of like my mistakes, basically, that I make in building my deck or whatever comes next. So without further ado, let's begin.
Okay, time to figure out what's on this thing.
I think I'll change that just so I can have like something to like check the levels against. Does that mean that I can do this now? Yeah. Maybe I need to lower the game audio slightly more. Is that enough, do you reckon? I'll raise the mic slightly, but not to the point of it being a problem. Okay. Okay. Guess we'll be continuing. Suit. Sacrifices must be made. Oh yeah, the... Wait, so is that like a squirrel pile there? On the left? Just moving the keyboard closer. Huh? All right. Well, I can't do anything. Oh, that would be interesting. So I put it on at the beginning and then use it as, like, a reagent. Damage from its poison. Oh, right, yeah, yeah. I've seen one of these in, like, Shadowverse and whatnot. Oh, Give me a sec. I think I'm going to go with the cat. Again, going to mess with levels again. Sorry about this. Hopefully that's a little better. Oh, so that's going to be in for the side. By the way, I do know about this thing already and its purpose. Though we did kind of hint at it there. Bearing this sigil will grow into a more powerful form after one turn on the board. Okay, right. And this is done in such a way that I can't actually attack it. The items are fine, don't worry, but... So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put... the cat wait how Oh. Wait, that's what the red thing is. Okay. So can I put the stout on as well? I think that'll be my turn. See, I should have put it there, shouldn't I? But it requires two sacrifices anyway, so... Alright. So either do we go literally turtling, or do we go with the high damage output? Let's see. What is... the bat again. Oh yeah, move over. Even if there is a creature opposing it, an opponent directly. Does that mean that if it will attack me, like on the scales, and it'll attack for two, but it has one health? Right. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to save the turtle for when the boulder falls, because then it will be in front of the wolf cub. So, I'm either going to keep the stoat as it is and just pass the turn anyway, or sacrifice the stoat to get... Yeah, let's do that. Let's get the wolf out there. Two sacrifices, one... Wait, can I... No. Okay, right. There we go. Flies over creatures. Okay, right. Okay, that's what it meant. Yeah, and it was right. So, I'm gonna need the cat, and I'm gonna need a squirrel. But then again, I don't... Right, yeah, so I pick up the squirrel now. I place the squirrel down here. And then... But, again, I said... Because it's doing 3 damage per turn. I'll just have to leave it like that. And as much as it feels like it's the wrong decision... See, it's only got 1 health, this boulder. So if I... That will run out after their next turn. You can play a squirrel and also sacrifice... Yeah, I know. I know what it meant. I just didn't want to do it. So I'm going to sacrifice the cat and the squirrel. I'm going to take this. So I've got my backup. I'm going to place the river snapper. Oh yeah. And the squirrel. And then place that there. So then I'm doing three through the open gap. And I should be able to survive two opposing turns without getting attacked by this wolf. There we go. It's another choice. No, I don't really want... Oh, but then again, it only requires one sacrifice. So if I've got the cat out, then I can put the wolf cub on the board. Inexpensive if feeble flying creature. See, they both only have one, but the wolf cub can... Wolf cub can grow over time, but the sparrow can... Can I check my deck? No, it won't let me check my deck. See, this is a tough one. Because it says opponent. Does that mean that, like, if I'm behind boulders, I can still attack? Because I only need 5, don't I? I only need 5 HP gone. Do you know what? Yeah, sparrow. I can regret it later, it's fine. No, I'm not. No. Lost River. Oh well, then I'll get rid of the sparrow then. If those are the only two choices I have, it has to be the sparrow. It has to be. Yeah, because I need the cat. It's fine. I don't know what this is doing now. So are they powering up? Are they powering up my sparrow? Joe, let's just go with this, because then I've either got a more powerful sparrow and I don't need a more powerful cat anyway. Ah. So now that's got airborne, which has got one more health, even if it only does one attack. Right, okay. But then again, if I've... Since I've got the Sparrow, it can now be a bit of a tug of war. Right, so where are they? Coyote has airborne. Bat already has airborne. So that's two per turn. And Squirrel does no damage, right? Okay. I remember the items you gave me. I'm refusing to use them. See, it seems way too early to use one of these. But then again, I'm gonna lose 4 HP on the next turn anyway. See, if I put the wolf in the open space, it does 3 damage to him and then 2 to me. If I put the river snapper, I do no points of damage to him, but I only get 2 done to me on his turn. But then again, when the next card's going to appear. Oh. Actually, that's it. This is stupid, but I'm going to go with it. Because it's the first turn and I haven't had a chance to pick up a squirrel, I'm going to take that. I'm going to place the squirrel down. And then put the... Oh wait, they've only got one. They've got one HP. So that means that I can kill either of them on this turn, even with the river snapper. Well, the thing is, I've got two wolves and a... No, I didn't take the cub, did I? I'm on the back foot here, so I'll put the river snapper down. I'm probably going to regret this, but let's see. What? 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 Wait, why did it not take damage? Oh, does it only like deal damage on its next turn? Okay, let's take a squirrel, place a squirrel down, and then sacrifice the two of them to the wolf. Ah, there we go. Wait. Oh, that was his turn. Also, can they only, like, actually attack once they get on adjacent spaces? Which is, I guess, what we're going to find out now. Well, there's no point in going for the squirrel when I don't have anything to summon. Right, so... To watch me suffer. The cat is all that's required. Back on the board. Okay, yes. Is that... Well, then, hopefully, I could, that'll be 1, 2, 5. So we'll be back on... In, it'll be advantage us. Yeah. Wolf. And that is the last card in my deck. Okay. Do I have a card I want to give Stinky to? Ah, that'll be a quite good one to do. Because then it like extends the advantage that the turtle has on its high HP. There we go. Also blocks me from putting a card down. That's very much you wouldn't download a bear energy. And so I'm protected from one attack there. I could probably put my stinky turtle there if I've got it. Oh wait, no, I can't, can I? Squirrel on the open space. Cat to summon on the open space. And then I'll have to wait a turn. Which is dangerous because... Yeah. Because I'm about to be on like 1 HP away from death. And that will at least hold the sparrow for 3 turns. So... Because I don't want to waste the wolf. Especially if I only got 2 of them. But the thing is, I can't put a turtle down next... We'll see, okay. Anyway, we're going to be at -4. And hope this is the turtle. Yep. It's the turtle. There we go. Reduce its attack. So I should survive 2 turns, but then it wouldn't have made a difference anyway. Oh, this is going to be difficult because now I can't move the cat. I think I'm going to have to wait until the sparrow destroys the fair, and then I can kill it in one turn with the wolf. So, three left there. The wolf's going to die next turn. The sparrow's going to destroy that next turn. And that's where I'm going to put the next card. The cat is dead next turn as well. The grizzly... The grizzly's also going to kill the turtle and then go back up to four. Ooh, this is a mess. There we go, dead. Oh, I thought it was like a walk around thing. What am I looking for? A candlestick? So a massive sacrifice for something that's basically unstoppable. Or something with a slightly lower cost that can just like eat through anything. I think that Adder is probably the correct choice. But I like me some big numbers, so we're going with the big numbers. Right, well, that's that answered. Wait, only one? Mule's key. To the right. He'll go across. So does he mean that we need to kill the mule, or that we need to kill it, keep it alive? Because those are different. And I don't know. So maybe we can kill this on this turn, if we use the stoat. It's only got 1 HP, right? And not... Oh! I forgot it attacks the boss and not him. Right, that's what Airborne does. So that's now he's gonna kill my stoat immediately. And then... Shit. God damn it. Right, fuck it, let's go with the goat. Oh, we need to sacrifice as well. Shit. This is a really dumb turn. That's all I can do. I literally can't do anything else. Let's see what happens. Oh! Shit! What? So I need to kill one of these, basically, on this turn now. It's gotta be the porcupine, hasn't it? Oh, draw a card. So I'll go with squirrel. Porcupine. Oh, and then also the grizzly's going to be attacking him, so that's not going to be too bad either. I think that's all I can do. Not too bad, considering. Alright, we'll use the squirrel then the wolf. Do you know what? Yeah, fuck it. Then the wolf. I mean, the sacrifice is going to be required anyway, so... That should be it. Oh, fuck you. So we'll move back and forth between rows. That's what that means. Squirrel, squirrel, and then we'll place the wolf in front of the bloodhound. That's all I can do. And I'll take 2 damage on the scales next turn. So I just saw the adder. So obviously I don't want to hit that. Is it also includes? Oh, it's just the creature it damages. Right, okay. Because I was wondering whether it was like poisonous in addition to it being venomous. So like if I attack it, like it makes me poisoned and then I die, if you get me. I'm not putting the cat down yet. That's for sure. In any case, it's 2 versus 3 so far, which means that I'm gonna be still moving the scales in the right direction. Sorry, I'm gonna change the audio again because I can't actually check it while I'm streaming. It just keeps getting louder, so. And also, I can't tell how it actually sounds. So it could be that I'm just go. 2 down my direction. Okay. None of these is a. Oh, only the cat is a 1-cost card. It feels unwise to just burn it on 1 turn. So I'm going to lose 3, which will mean I'm down to 1. So we're like an even keel at the moment until he puts whatever he is putting there. Basically, I just don't want my cat to immediately die, is the thing. Which might still happen anyway, but... the other scroll in the empty slot, and then summon. What shall I summon? Because then I'll be doing 5 damage on the scales. I think the snapper turtle is what I'm going to put here when this breaks. So... so let's kill the coyote for now. Oh wait, no, I can't kill the coyote because it's fucking airborne. Jesus Christ. God damn it. Shit. Oh wait, have I won anyway though? I've won anyway. Well, that was fucking stupid. Just fucking click the bell and be done. There we go. And why are these, I don't think I've been to a bonfire thing, so what's this? Thank you. But why did it act like it was... It acted like it was airborne. Does it not... Oh! If it's on that, it doesn't get attacked. Right, okay. Right. Lesson learned, I guess. And it also doesn't get attacked. You're gonna die if I put you down there. The cat's dead, so I need... Is that 3 or 4? Yeah, it's 3. It's not 4. Six. Joe, I'll use it anyway. But I'm probably going to need to survive this next attack. Also, if I put this in front of the one of the adders, then it won't take damage, will it? Yeah. So hopefully that won't cause anything, but it will also mean that I'm going to lose next turn anyway. Bloody idiot. Alright, we're done. We're done this run. So that's a blood thing? Wait, so today I've only got one single sacrifice. Sacrifice card. I got the stone, and there's one other, I think. Oh, so that's like stealth. Do I have to step in this bear trap here? Right, so I'll put the stoat in the open space. Right, well, fuck you, idiot. So the cat's going to die next turn anyway. Right, so that'll do one damage to my wolf. The cat can't do any damage anyway. See, if I had a two-cost card, I could do this easily. Yeah. Once I get the grizzly on the board, I wanna... Right, so 1, 2 are going to go through. Oh, yeah, I forgot because they were on the thingy. Oh, yeah, they're above. They're airborne. I forgot. Shit. God damn it. But then that's why my cat's still alive, I guess. Alright, squirrel, squirrel, grizzly, for all three. And so I'm nearly dead, but... I do like that you when you go back here. Oh, you arsehole. Shit! God damn it. So that's my default stout now. So I need to have the bones already, so I can't actually... Oh, Jesus Christ, I'm... But now I can spend the bones anyway. This game is really good at, like, making me fall into mistakes. Which is good, because I was worried that, well, I'd be too good at it. It's because I've played deck builders before, and turns out that's not the case at all. Okay. There we go. So if you're wondering whether I'm going to go through all 1,000 combinations just to see if it'll let me, the answer is it going to stop me? Right, so let's treat the bottom one as the units and then the tens and then the hundreds. Though for some reason the numbers go backwards then. Right, so that's that. Now let's start like this. So it's 9999. So we're at 900, so we've gone through 99 of the combinations so far, so that's like a tenth. Okay. So unless I need to, like, wait and delay for each one, then we're, like, a fifth of the way through now. So we're halfway through, and it's not hit yet, but I'll keep going. Even if I'm doing something wrong, that it, like, it won't activate for whatever reason, I'm still gonna do it because of. I'm like that. I'm a bit bloody minded when it comes to things like this, and I'm not a fan of puzzles. It feels like the game's kind of daring me to do this, in a sense. Or, like, saying, oh, well, no one's gonna do this. And then I do. Oh shit! Can I? Now, what the hell is this? Oh no, don't make me do it again. Chainsaw? I know it's a book. Sorry, it's just that it looks quite jagged on my screen. Six, though. I don't know how that relates to anything. But I know that it definitely does. Oh, the wolf cub only does one damage for now. I just want to see how this works, basically. So I'm gonna try. Oh, it's bones. Right, okay, that's it. That explains it. That explains it. If I put it there, then it'll get attacked. The just the only thing I can actually do. This isn't going to kill the wolf, is it? Oh no, it is. Right, okay. That's fine then. Oh, it just leaps up. It's not airborne. Right. So we've got two... Ah. Ah. Gonna put the stink bug in front of the opossum, so now it does zero damage. That's all I can do for... Oh. So, three next turn, unless I get blocked. Wait, they not move? Oh well, fine, that's done. Why not? Can I put myself on the fire? Well, it says creature, so maybe not. So do I need to put something in front of it that isn't gonna seem tasty? What's this? A bird in a raven, maybe? Ah. So it turns everyone into a leaping thing. Two health, so we want to have something with... with at least two attack. Doesn't matter where I put it, I'm going to put the stoat in the open space. Yeah, I'll try. Well, let's see if it'll attack the one of the sparrows. Because it's got the leap, or if that's only for like defensive purposes, like, you know, it's got a shield there, so it probably is, but oh, it did, but
give me my, take my teeth, please, take my teeth.
Two bones. There we go. What? I think we'll look at your pelts.
Oh, do I have any gold? Teeth. How many do I have, though?
Literally none. Okay. Right, well then I don't have it. Yeah, so the like junk that like takes place in my deck, then
God.
One sec, I'm just See, it says that, but then I can at least block a single attack from a non-airborne enemy. Porcupine, Three bones? Okay. So it's going to do one damage to me. Guess we'll see if that continues, if it, that also counts as an attack. So it was just the one. Yes, I'm sure. Fuck off. Looks like we're winning the next turn. Probably. I need to be okay with sacrificing the stoat, I think. Ah, cockroach. So use the cockroach to block, and then hopefully that'll be fine. Yeah, should be it. I'm getting a good feeling about the turkey vulture. It's unlikely we'll ever get to it. Mole. No damage, but... Shut up. I'll decide what's a bad play. Alright, so I've got enough of the cockroach. And those have only got one health, so... He also doesn't have a thing for, like, giving canines the ability to, like, fly. See, that was a bad play. It was definitely not going to be worth it. See, I should have saved it for that. God. One, two, three. One, two, oh yeah. No, no, I. Oh, God, damn it. I forgot about this. Wait, how many squirrels I've got first? One, two, three. Thank you. When this, the card bearing this sigil is played, you will receive a random item as long as your pack is not full. Well, since my cards keep dying all the damn time, it's going to be Ouroboros, isn't it? That's a one cost card, so I'm going to get that. That seems to be like, I'm guessing, a remove card from your deck, and I don't feel like that. What do I want to strengthen? Oh. I think I'm fully on tilt, so I'll probably have to stop in a sec. Basically, in my next death, I'm gonna stop. Which I think is gonna be pretty soon. Because I'm making a lot of unforced errors at the moment. Bees with it. Sprinter. So that way. See, I can't kill that, and it can't kill me. Wait, if they're moving one... Some Norboros. Just because that way at least it will have been revived and it'll be slightly stronger. Oh no, I do have four. I'll leave it for this turn and then I'll decide.
Right, three of those. You know what, fuck it, let's use this. Oh wait, no. Next turn. Shit. Ah. Oh, well, that was easy. The pack rat, because I was wondering about that one earlier. I wish I could put that on my other river otter, but I think I'm going to have to get the elk. Oh, wait, what's this? Hoarder, when a card bearing this sigil is played, you must search your deck for any card and take it into your hand. Oh, of my choice. No, go with the elk. Come on, let's see what they do. Is that it? Have I fucked up the game? I think I might have to start again. I think I might have completely fucked up the game and might need to start from a fresh save. This game was already a lot. So maybe I'll be fine if I go at it with a fresh mind, but this is just going to be me fully on tilt, and it's going to be really bad. But it's a really interesting game for all the reasons that I assumed it would be. But I do feel exhausted. And maybe see you for another one of these? But I've no idea, honestly.